please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Rags to riches story, Guo Guangchang defied the odds, skillfully evolving a business over the years to create a $50 billion empire. Today on Managing Asia, I catch up with the chairman of Fosun International. Right on the Banyan, Shanghai, overlooking the famous Huangpu River, lies the headquarters of Fosun, the heart of the empire Guo Guangchang built. He showed me his office, a sharp contrast to the billionaire's humble beginnings. Born into a farming family, he and three classmates founded a startup that grew into one of China's largest private companies, winning him this station's Lifetime Achievement Award in 2017.
Thank you.
I feel that we're on a journey. There is still a long way to go. Another important aspect would be learning. Fosun began without technology, talent, and capital. We had to learn faster than others.
A lifetime of learning, balancing the shifting economic winds. The Tai Chi enthusiast skillfully evolved Fosun over the years, diversifying from property and pharmaceutical to steel and mining, and later insurance, tourism, and healthcare. His bold vision grabbed the world's attention when he bought into well-known brands like Club Med, Cirque du Soleil, and Silver Cross, expanding the company's presence across the globe.
Fosun is now a global company. We have investments in 16 countries, but our foundation remains in China, and we hope that after integrating domestic growth with global resources, customers will be able to enjoy better products and services. This is Fosun's approach.
Earlier this year, Chinese regulators, in a drive to reduce financial risk and leverage in the system, issued a directive restricting Chinese companies from making investment overseas in certain sectors like real estate, hotels, entertainment, and sports clubs. Have you had to adjust your acquisition strategy as a result?
Firstly, it is understandable that the Chinese government issued a directive aimed at reducing financial risks and leverage in the system. At the same time, when we communicate with the relevant departments on making investments overseas, we know that they're still supportive without imposing restrictions. We've seen us complete our acquisition of India's Gland Pharma this year. We've also seen our continued investment in French company Saint-Hubert, a century-old food enterprise. So there is no impact on these. On the other hand, Fosun is a Hong Kong-listed company, and we have the ability to attract funding overseas. I believe the government initiative is beneficial to Fosun and will not affect our development.
This deal that you talked about, acquiring a 74% stake in India's Gland Pharma, you also went on to buy French margarine maker Saint-Hubert and also a German automobile parts supplier, Koller Belitogorsk. Yeah, yeah. Did the deals you carried out in the last couple of months come under any regulatory scrutiny? Did you have to go through any approval process?
We feel that these investments are in line with the country's direction as well as our shareholders' interests. They're also in line with our core approach of integrating global resources to better serve and produce for our family customers. So we don't see any scrutiny in the process, and we believe we'll receive support from all parties.
When it comes to future deals, do you feel that there might be a certain kind of protocol you would have to go through just to get the deals done?
Let me restate that the Chinese government still supports regular and legitimate investments overseas, so we don't feel that there are other problems. The government has done all the regulatory checks for our Gland Pharma acquisition, There are very clear guidelines and procedures when investing Chinese money overseas. We went through all these checks. It was the same in the past, and it will be in the future, including some of our projects that are being processed and cleared right now. We don't feel any change. It is still a very transparent process.
State banks have been asked to assess the level of lending to Fosun and other Chinese conglomerates. To what extent do you rely on Chinese state banks to fund your acquisitions overseas?
It is normal for any banks to run due diligence to alleviate and address any concerns around conflicts of interest. This is normal, but there could have been some exaggeration that might have caused misunderstandings in some areas.
So it won't affect your financing?
I believe the government and banks, when it comes to normal investments overseas, will follow market principles and not be affected by anything else.
Given the pressure from investors and regulators, you've reduced your net debt to equity ratio from 60.3% at the end of last year to 47.7% at the end of June. Could this number fall below 40% by the end of this year?
It is Fosun's strategy to maintain a good net debt to equity ratio and not be influenced by other aspects. We'll maintain a reasonable debt to equity ratio and keep increasing our rating. This is our core strategy for the last 5 to 10 years. As you can see, our debt to equity ratio has been decreasing. I would also like to stress that when it comes to debt to equity ratio, it is not always the case that the lower it is, the better. After all, we're a company with investment funds, and right now our debt to equity ratio is on the low side. I personally feel that it's more reasonable at around 60%. This will show stability and demonstrate accomplishments to our shareholders, so we will maintain a reasonable net debt to equity ratio. There is no intention to lower it. In fact, we want to raise it a little to around 60%.
Well, since 2011, Fosun spent something like $11 billion doing mergers and acquisitions overseas. What are you looking to buy next? What's next on your acquisition list?
We're always focused on two pillars, internal organic growth and external development. Fosun is not pressured to make a fixed number of acquisitions. It all goes back to our main purpose of serving the needs of our global customers better in areas of health, happiness and wealth, and to integrate our resources globally as best we can. We've never given ourselves pressure on how many acquisitions to make. Of course, internal organic growth and external acquisitions remains our core strategy. We're always on the lookout for strategic acquisitions that can meet our needs, but we are not tied to a target.
If you had to buy a company, what criteria would you look at?
Most importantly, it must match Fosun's strategy and be part of our broader ecosystem. Secondly, acquisitions need to leverage and tap into Chinese growth momentum and help us integrate resources better globally. So whether it's Club Med or Saint-Hubert, the strategy remains. The cultures of the companies must be similar. We must learn faster than others and constantly upgrade ourselves. Of course, the price must be suitable.
Any opportunities, any investment opportunities related to One Belt, One Road that you're looking at?
All the investments made by Fosun matches the initiative of One Belt, One Road, as well as the country's strategy. That's not to say we invest specifically with One Belt, One Road in mind, or that our deals fit completely into that strategy. Of course, we feel that One Belt, One Road is a win-win initiative and is good for the global economy. Such a program will receive positive response, and we believe it will be met with more support and traction globally.
Just between you and me, could you do a few more deals by the end of the year?
I have numerous ongoing projects, and we have no time target to make sure we close them by the end of the year. I believe, though, we have a few in the pipeline.
Fosun is listed in Hong Kong. Last fiscal 2016, Fosun posted record earnings up 27.7% for the year. How do you expect to do this fiscal year? Could it be another record year for you?
I'm very thankful for the team and all employees for their collective hard work. which contributed to our strong first half earnings. We believe we'll achieve good results in the second half of the year, but because we are listed, I can't disclose the numbers to you. However, if we look at the profits earnings in the next 3 to 5 years, especially in the profit growth of our core products, that's in line with our strategy and the One Fosun motto. I'm filled with confidence.
Well, net earnings last year reached 10 billion RMB for the first time in the company's history. How fast do you expect to grow from here?
I
believe our growth will not be too bad. In the next 5 to 10 years, a stable growth can be expected. With a good team and a good strategy focus on the family, I believe there'll be pretty good growth this year. Building on the foundations last year, we'll have a pretty good growth.
Do you have a number to give me?
Because we're a listed company, I'm unable to give a specific figure. Anyway, it'll be good growth.
What is 不错的增长?
这个你猜吧?
You can guess.
Are you still aiming for assets to reach 1 trillion RMB in the next 3 years?
This will be a natural process without a clear goal. Our goal is to do the right thing, the difficult thing, even if it takes us a long time to accomplish. Our goal is to better serve our customers. Asset growth is only natural in this process. It's not our fixed goal. It will be achieved naturally.
All eyes are on the recent 19th Communist Party Congress and the new political lineup. As the chairman of Fosun, how do you and the business community here in China feel about President Xi Jinping and his new cabinet? Is it good for the growth of private enterprise here in China?
I feel that is very good. Private enterprises like mine and others in general are heartened by the development and report, as it clearly lays out China's strategy, roadmap and specific goals. It's not only important to Chinese enterprises, overseas companies and international politicians also respect the Communist Party Congress and the new political lineup. With this, China will be more open. It will speed up its reforms. Its economy will grow steadily. We are very confident of the development as well as Fosun.
You worried about U.S.-China relations as a result of what's happening in the U.S. with President Donald Trump?
I believe that both political leaders are wise enough to lead and make the right choices, so I'm not worried that both countries will face many challenges. Even if there are, they'll be resolved. U.S.-China cooperation will then benefit the citizens, their economies, as well as the global economy.
You don't see tensions rising as a result?
There will still be challenges and dilemmas, but I believe both are wise enough to resolve them with their wisdom. The future will only be better.
China's growth is slowing down. The PBOC has set a growth target of 6.5% this year. As a chairman of Fosun, are you still betting on rising household income to drive some of the growth in the sectors that you're in, like entertainment and healthcare?
Firstly, I would like to say, as the world's second biggest economy, over 6% growth is pretty good, as the market size is massive. Secondly, future growth will come from the needs and demands of people looking towards building a beautiful life, for instance, being healthier, happier, and wealthier. So what Fosun is doing is to satisfy these needs. There's a great space for growth in this area. Look at China now. Our debt-to-income ratio is at the lowest, so there is room to grow. In the next 5 to 10 years, consumer spending will grow faster than GDP. And I think this is a good thing. Chinese consumers have greater spending power, and this can boost growth, sparking positive growth, which drives our strategic thinking, and we remain confident in future growth.
Your success is a rags-to-riches story, As a farmer boy, together with three classmates, you co-founded Fosun and built it into one of China's largest private conglomerates. Were you relentless and determined to survive against all odds? You never gave up?
首先感谢这个时代啊。
I feel thankful for this era and what I mentioned, our ability to learn. It's not a matter of giving up because I always enjoy such a lifestyle. As an entrepreneur, this is what gives me a fulfilling lifestyle. Just like any job that others do. If I give it up, I have no idea what other lifestyles will be better for me. I chose it, I persevered, and I am happy. So giving up is not an option.
You've been called China's Warren Buffett, and you said before he's one of your role models. Any valuable lessons you've learned from the Oracle of Omaha?
I feel that we are Buffett's students. Most importantly, we learned two things from him. Firstly, to persevere in making strategic investments. Secondly, to have the dual focus of investment and insurance, which we take a leaf from. That is why we have the biggest insurance company in Portugal, and we will keep developing this sector. We will also focus on unlocking health insurance and medical insurance together with pharmaceutical and medical management to create a comprehensive solution for our customers. We do, after all, belong to a different generation as Buffett. I did not understand one of his concepts previously. He said he doesn't really like high-tech industries. But now I understand. In his time, to make light bulb accessible to everyone, it would take a very long process, as the global economy was not as connected then, and there wasn't the financial and resource capacity to scale production. As Fosun now strives to be a leading tech company, our thinking is different because the world is in a different place now. The rate of tech innovation is very fast. The time from labs to production to products being in the global market has shortened by so much. It means that if you can take the lead in innovative technology, you can take the lead in the global economy. This helps to better serve your customers faster. In order for Fosun to become a leading innovation company, we have to be different from Buffett. While we need to learn from him, we do not necessarily have to copy everything he does, because we both come from a different era. What we need to learn is the logic behind his concepts, why he had his ideas, and how we can find answers in his logic in today's times.
Have you ever met Warren Buffett in person?
Yes, I have met him twice, including once when he came to China. And the other time when President Xi brought us to the US for a conference. I'm honored to learn from him.
Did you ask him for advice?
I feel that to learn about enterprise is not just to ask him a few questions or to see what he had done in the long term. It's to analyze the logic behind his decisions and actions, decisions that are worth learning. It's too superficial to just meet him and ask him a few questions. Whether it's an hour long or a few minutes, you won't be able to learn anything. It is more about learning his character face to face when you meet him. In order to truly understand an enterprise, you need to look at what he has invested, his decisions and the logic behind them, as well as his thought process. His letter to stakeholders annually is also a good source of wisdom, and a deeper approach is what we truly need to learn.
You co-founded Fosun 25 years ago, built it into a Chinese conglomerate with operations in more than 50 countries. As chairman of Fosun, what role do you play in the company? Do you still make all the decisions, or do you spend most of your time mapping out the vision of the company?
I do not make all the decisions, but I participate in all the important decisions. I think a good decision is not made by one person. It is a process of sharing the wisdom involving everyone from the human resource department to legal entities and lawyers. There is no perfect decision. All you can do is balance the risks and benefits to business. So to speak, it's a decision-making process by all. This is how Fosun makes all its decisions. Of course, in very challenging times, I cannot escape being the sole decision-maker. This is my job. I enjoy this role and the responsibility.
How would you describe your leadership and your management style? What are you like as the chairman of Fosun?
My leadership style is as follows. When I know that someone in the team knows more than me, I can let them take the lead without saying a word. For instance, if we go to a place and I believe that there is a person who knows the way, I will follow the person. If the team does not know how to move, I will step up to decide how we should do that. I am not a one-sided leader, where what I say is final. I am also definitely not a lazy and irresponsible leader. So I think it's important to be both a team player as well as a person who is determined to lead the team. So I think it is important to be both a team player as well as a person who's determined to lead the team. It has to be a combination of both. I think it is a balance.
Here in China, the world of business and private enterprise is often intertwined very closely with politics, with the state. As chairman of Fosun, how do you manage this very delicate relationship with the Chinese government and still keep focus on running the business?
For the first 30 to 40 years, the Chinese government focused on fulfilling the basic needs of its people. Now, whether it is the government or private enterprises, the main focus is to fulfill the needs of people to pursue a beautiful life. What we need to do is to provide better products and solutions for their pursuit. Fosun's objectives are in line with what the government and citizens want. There is no need to communicate intentionally. I am deeply appreciative of the anti-corruption drive in the last few years, which I found to be impressive. Through the exercise, the relationship between the government and enterprise becomes simpler, aligning all of our priorities under the guidance of the market and leaders. Here are a few words of wisdom by the leader of Zhejiang that sums up our vision as well. The government is competent, the market is efficient, and enterprises can thrive in a relatively transparent and stable environment. So I feel that the overall system is getting better. There's no need to do anything else except to do a good job in whatever you are doing already.
So you find and you feel that you have the full backing and the support of the Chinese government behind what you're trying to do, building the business?
Of course, I feel that the government's support to Chinese enterprise is consistent. The development of private enterprise is a very important part of the whole Chinese economy. For companies like Fosun, every step we take is inseparable from the country's strategy.
And finally, you've just been given the Lifetime Achievement Award by CNBC, this network here in Shanghai. What advice can you give others on how to create great, successful businesses?
Learning is very important. Secondly, the team and its people are important. Fosun takes pride in being a global enterprise, and in some ways we are different from other enterprises. We have a partnership system with partners from 28 different countries. I always tell my employees that Fosun is a global enterprise from China. So when it comes to manpower, we cannot solely rely on Chinese people. We must engage people internationally, regardless of their race and nationality. Fosun is giving equal opportunities for them to develop. This is very important. In the future, Fosun aims to hire more talents in digital and technology.